life story. So, you are going to write a book about my husband, and I would like to help you all I can. Of course, you know of his worldwide fame as a pianist, but perhaps you are not also knowing that he was quite a family man. A book about my husband, you know, I think he would laugh if he could know. He did not take himself so serious. No, no. We were both students when we met and we get married. I was in music then. A singer with piano for second subject. But of course, when the children come along, you cannot have two full-time musicians in one family if one of you is going off on tour, that sort of thing. And so somebody stays home, it was me, and I was doing the lullabies and all the first little piano lessons for the children. Yes, I still play the piano a little bit. I still sing, yes, nothing, you know what, just for my own amusement. I think I would say that my husband was, what is your word? Gregarious. He was very popular from the beginning. I would say he had a hospitable heart. No, you know, I am never going to Australia. My husband is going there. Clara Ross, the singer. Oh, yes, she was a friend for my husband. What a voice. When she is coming to London, you know, she is coming many times to our home, and I am hearing her in concert. I think one of the great singers. The South African writer, Martha Vanderbilt. Yes, that is right. No, I am never going to South Africa either. There are many places I am not going. But Martha Vanderbilt is a friend for my husband, and she is having this most beautiful place, I think is called Natal, and she's having a garden there. And when he is making a big concert tour, and he is going there for a holiday afterwards, and there is flowers and the beaches and the birds and all that, do you know, sometimes now, I feel I am going to those places because he wrote me so marvelous, the letters. I feel I have the letters. We can use them. I think they are going to be most useful. I don't know what I would say was his most favorite kind of music. Of course, many piano recitals and concerti with orchestra. But I think perhaps he is liking to play chamber music, perhaps most. Yes, he is playing for many, many years with the French violinist Clotilde Nilsson. Yes, many recitals. Yes, they go on many tours. And then latterly there was the Olga Velice, the cellist, and also many, many tours. You know, when my husband was away, he would write the children little tunes, such homesick tunes for them to play, you know, on the piano. I think people do not understand the life for a musician. It's not just the applause and the platform and the concert. It is the long journeys. It is the time changes, the airplanes, the trains, you know, different foods, all that kind of thing. It's away from home for a very long time. America. He loved America. He said the best audience in the world for music is now in America because that is where all the Europeans are. And Hollywood, yes, in the days when Hollywood was a place, you know. Shirley Brewster, the comedian, ah, she is our family favorite. I think she is so funny. I like her so much. I did not know she was a friend for my husband. He had very good taste. Now, you are going to write a book about my husband, and I am going to help you all I can. There is just one thing I would ask that you should know and perhaps you will remember. My husband always, he always came home to me.